the tide turns. Mighty shark stalks his prey. Now we strike to the briny deep. I'll show them a watery grave.
Hey guys, welcome back to a new guy video. Today I'll show you how to play the AP Assassin Fizz. Early game guys, you can either start with your W or your E. It totally depends on the matchup. If you're playing against someone who can harass you level 1, like an Akali for example, then you can start your E. First cast of your E will make you go untargetable, and then if you just let it fully cast, then once you land, then you will deal damage in an AoE while also slowing targets. Now if you recast it immediately, then you will just damage, but the zone will be much smaller. This is like your main waveclang ability, and it can also be used to hop over walls and such, and mainly to dodge abilities as well. You just stay back honestly, because Fizz doesn't really do anything once you get at least level 3, so you have all your basic abilities unlocked, so you just stay back and let the opponent push all the time. That's what you want to do, and once you hit level 3, that's when you start looking for traits. W guys, once you use it, it will make your auto attacks deal bonus damage, but if you use it to kill something, then that ability will reset, refunding some of the mana cost, so it's very very good for last hitting minions under the tower. And remember, it is an auto attack reset, that's also really important, so when you like go for traits, then you want to auto attack and then immediately press W, so you get the damage off really fast. And your Q will make you dash through the target, and it is a fixed distance, and it will also proc on hit. Thing is, if you don't last hit something with your W guys, then it's just going to stay activated, giving you bonus damage for a short duration on your auto attacks. So once you have all of your basic abilities unlocked, now we are level 4, we had 2 points in our E. This is like a basic trade, you go in with your Q, then you auto attack, and then you immediately press W to reset that auto attack, and then you can either fully commit to the fight by E'ing on top of them, or you can use that E to get out with. There we got that electrocute proc as well. Now what makes Fizz really really strong is that he can actually pressure people under their own tower. You do the same thing again, you Q to them, and then you W, and then you can just use that E to get out, because if the tower is targeting you and the auto attack went through, once you press that E, then that auto attack is going to disappear because you go untargetable. So we got the kills, we just had to reset because this wave is going to push into us because there's a cannon minion, so we can just peace out. Now the really important part comes is that you want to get a dark seal and a drawn string. You get that dark seal because Fizz is an AP assassin. So you are supposed to snowball early game, so you get a lot of free AP from that, and then you can also upgrade it later. Doran String and a Dark Seal early on basically gives you a really strong early game, so you can help survive and stall until you have enough levels to trade with people. Boss, E ability is your main wave clear, and it's also your mobility. So you want to be really careful with how you use it, because a lot of people will wait using their abilities until you use that, so you want to try bait it out. An ally has been slain. And now we got an ultimate, guys. So once you have level 6, that's why you normally have a lot of kill pressure on Fist. So when you use that ultimate, then you're going to throw this skill shot that will attach to a champion. And after short duration, then this shark will appear, knocking them up. Now what's really, really important to know is that this gives you true sight. So if Akali goes into a shroud, then she will still be visible. And that's actually what we did right here. So, you know, targets that are invisible, you can use that ultimate to reveal them. It's going to reveal them while it's attached to them. So normally into a matchup like Akali, who's supposed to be really, really hard for Fizz. At level 6, that's why you can start looking for kills. But yeah, so once you get that ultimate, that's when you want to look for kills and really try to snowball the game. Now we can go for Lucidity Boots, because Ability Haste is key on Fizz, because you want low cooldown on all of your basic abilities, so you can really spam them and also become super mobile, so it's very hard for people to pretty much fight back against you. That's why he's known for being such a slippery assassin. He's so hard to chase down. There we go, that's a really nice trade, and that's basically how you want to do it. Also, when you try to harass people under their own tower, you want to do that Q into auto attack into W reset, and then just E out. This is something you can do under the tower without taking a single turret shot. Of course, go for that W max second after your E. Always do that. Never do the Q max second. That's really awful. Of course, when you want to push waves, just auto attack all of the minions a couple times and then you E so it can finish them off. If you don't max out your E first, then you will lose all of your wave clearing capabilities, so you're pretty much not a mid laner at that point. That ultimate was a bit terrible, but yeah, it is a skill shot, so very easy to dodge as well. Do keep in mind though that the ultimate deals more damage the further it travels. So if you use it in melee range, then of course it's not going to deal a lot of damage. You mainly use it in melee range if you can already kill the target, but you just want to make sure that they don't escape. So if you are 100% certain that you have enough damage, then you can do that. Otherwise you want to go for long range ultimate for the highest possible damage. Yeah, going for the Sonya's Hourglass first, guys. This is very key on Fizz, because the moment you have Sonya's Hourglass on Fizz, then you can just dive people under the tower, use everything, and then use that Hourglass to reset. So it basically allows you to play much, much more aggressive, and that is key on Assassins. Oh, top lane is doing pretty well this game. That's always good to see. Also, another important thing, guys, you probably saw it in the combos, but yeah, you can hide your ultimate animation in your Q. And that is the most OP thing about Fizz, because the opponent cannot react to it. They have to know it's coming, because it's almost impossible to react to. So even if they have flash up or mobility or something, then you can often catch them off guard because they cannot see that ultimate coming. But that is something most Fizz players make use of in the laning phase to sneak in those early kills and then really snowball through that. And if I didn't mention early on, then his passive, guys, it's a you are permanently ghosted, so it means that you cannot be body blocked, so you basically just walk through everything. That is extremely useful, especially when you fight in a giant minion wave, then you make sure that you don't have to like walk around them, but you just walk straight through them. And of course you also take less damage from auto attacks, so that's nice for early game, you know, when people try to poke you down with auto attacks early game, especially long range champs. But in exchange for that, he does have low base armor, so good, depending on how you look at it, because against AD Assassin, then of course low base armor is very, very terrible. But he does go Sonya's Hourglass as his first completed core item, so you will get some extra armor to kind of make up for that passive. Wow, that's a that's a questionable teleport coming in, and ultimate. We committed way too much for that play at the bottom side, but got that. This is how you animation cancel the ultimate, guys. Just Q through something and then use ultimate at the same time. Right after you pass that target you Q through, that's when you use ultimate, because if you use it too early, then your ultimate will not travel that far. And top lane just got towered off. Wait, we're getting bottom side. That's Akali, okay. That's Akali coming in for a kill here. You see, this is how slippery Fizz is. I actually tried to like constantly move back and forth trying to dodge the second part of ultimate, because if I didn't, then I would have died. But yeah, this is a really terrible matchup for Fizz normally. Of course, if that Akali is really, really good, then you're going to struggle a lot until you have level 6. Because the only way you can kill her normally is if you attack her with that ultimate, because as I mentioned early on, the ultimate gives you true sight, so you'll be able to see her even in her shroud. If you don't attack her with that ultimate, then you're dead. You're going even, of course, because she's gonna win absolutely out DPS you, because you will not be able to target her. So she can pretty much dodge all of your damage while also dealing damage back. But yeah, now we have enough for the Sonya's Hourglass, and we also have enough for Magi's. Magi's is something you want to buy if you're snowballing, of course. If you're not, then you just skip it. But the thing is, since you're playing an AP Assassin, you want to be snowballing, so it can be really good to buy either way, because it teaches you to not greed, you know, because you really want to keep those stacks once you have them, so kind of teaches you how to play smarter. So just for improvement, then it can actually be really good to have this item, because you get punished really hard if you die. We can't really do anything here because all of them died, so I think, yeah, Kali just got 3 kills from that play right there. Oh, looks like they did have vision of me somewhere. I'm not sure why, where it was. But probably they just saw me earlier and expected me to camp in the brush, because that's what you want to be doing as Fizz. You're an assassin, so you just wait for people to walk into a trap and then just kill them. So mid game starting pretty early. This game is basically what you do mid game. You want to be most of the time in the side lane, because you have a lot of kill pressure in 1v1, and so you also want to abuse that. Thing is, in the side lane it's easier for you to look for kills as well, because it is an extended lane, and since Fizz is so mobile, it's very hard to escape from him. Now Yeah, once you snowball at this champ, guys, it is absolutely terrifying to play against him. He doesn't even need to hit his ultimate, just his basic abilities is enough to finish off the target. That's really nice. Basically, kited him and avoided all of his damage, otherwise I would probably die to his ultimate afterwards. Now we're gonna go for the Ludens Tempest. You've probably seen some people like to go for Night Harvester or Rocket Belt. Avoid doing that, guys, it's very terrible. First of all, Fizz is very, very mana hungry. If you don't have Ludens Tempest or Lyandra's Anguish, then you're going to run out of mana a lot of the time. On top of that, you don't really get that many useful stats from these items because Rocket Belt and Night Harvester has been nerfed quite a lot of times. With Ludens Tempest, you get a lot of free magic pen, guys. So if you're playing against a squishy team, then you can buy that. But if you're playing against a bruiser heavy comp or tank comp, then you can go for Lyandra's Anguish because it's a lot better against tankier targets. Ability haste is also another key factor when you go for these items because that's a very, very important stat on Fizz. We are picking up all of those skills here and that's completely fine because we are the assassin, so we want to snowball. As for the matchups, when you want to pick Fizz and when you don't want to, you can pick Fizz when you can see the enemy mid laner because he's very good against mages, you know, those squishy champions, but he struggles a lot into bruisers. And something like a Galio. Galio is like a big counter pick to him, and also bruisers, you know, like Lee Sin, Renekton, Pantheon, Aurelia, all those types of champs, he's going to struggle a lot. He's very good into squishy teams, but struggles against tankier ones. Especially bruisers, Pantheon, Zed, Aurelia, Galio, you know, all those types of champions are very hard counter picks. Also something like Renekton, yes, blind picking him can be risky. Kassadin is also a really terrible lane to play against because you can't really kill him and he's going to outscale you. So you can ban either of those champs depending on what you see the most in your elo. Now we have the Ludens Tempest, so that's a big power spike. Of course also when we damage someone, then we get bonus movement speed, so we are even more mobile, and now we want to go for Lichbane. Once we have Lichbane, then we have like the big power spike. Just gonna one tap people straight up. We don't even need the ultimate anymore. A lot of people do struggle staying up in CS, playing these assassins. It's very normal that you fall behind in CS a little bit compared to, you know, mages and such where you can really farm extremely well. But in order to minimize that loss, then just go to the side lane, pick up the waves and then rotate back. Just keep repeating that if you can't find any kills, and that way do not fall too far behind. I just need to be careful here because Akali can kill me. Don't have Sonya's Hourglass active up anymore. That's why I'm just staying back here. Actually it sucks that she had Ignite for me because I did lose some mid air stacks. You have Sinch pushing topside, so we're getting a tower, so it's fine, but I didn't have to die there. Wow, I think he committed way too hard, especially because it's a win. Now, it doesn't matter how many resistances you buy against her, because she has true damage on every third auto attack, so she's gonna strike you either way. Now, I'm gonna go to the sideline here. You know, if your opponent, the one you lane against, meets you in the sideline, then you have super high kill pressure. Especially if it's a mage. That's why you want to go to the sideline, kind of force them to come with you, and then you just run them down. You see, wave clear is also really good, guys. Just one E, and you absolutely destroy the entire wave, so having good wave clear is key because it allows you to push fast and then you can also rotate fast. It's really, really, really nice that your ultimate gives you that true sight, because otherwise you'll not be able to fight against targets like the Akali. You'll be an even bigger counter pick than she already was. It's very important that you also use that E to dodge. You know, I build this with because it's both your damage, your mobility, and on target ability. You have to be really smart with how you use it. Of course, later on in the game, once you have so much ability haste, then it's going to be on a really low cooldown. But early game, you have to be really careful. Now we can go ahead and buy Lich Bane. This is a good item first, of course. He's an AP assassin, and this is an assassination item because it gives a lot of burst. His Q and W procs on hit, of course, so it's going to proc that passive as well, so it gives you a lot more burst damage. And on top of that, you also get a lot more mobility. You have mobility for Magi's, and then you have for Lich Bane as well. It's a bit difficult to catch this guy because of his ultimate. Yeah, we should be able to go ahead and look for the end here. Oh, Cinch. Disrespect Wayne again. That's a terrible ultimate. I actually expected her to like maybe try to dodge it so she would dodge towards the bottom side, but she didn't, so that's a bit unfortunate, but as you can see, we have really low cooldown on that ultimate, so it doesn't really hurt that so much anyway. Just have to go for one fight here with everyone grouped, and then we just look to end because they don't have any towers left in the mid lane, and they also don't have the inhibitor up, so we have super minions coming in, so we just need to group, look for a fight, and then we end it. No fear. You see my target selection in fights, I am ignoring the bruisers, I'm just gonna go for the squishies, that's what we want to do as an assassin. Ignore the tanky targets, try to flank people, you know, so people don't focus you down before you actually enter the fight. Flank, wait for these squishies to use their movement abilities, and then just jump on them. Always go for the carries as the assassin. But yeah, that was the first guy videos. Of course, I hope this was helpful. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and see y'all in the next one.